Okay, some really good information, because the holiday season is actually a very good time to figure out if you or your loved one's experiencing any hearing loss. Zach Schaefer is here from Beltone with some warning signs. And I guess, Zach, this is the time of year when you get together, you don't see people all year long, you haven't seen them for several months, maybe a whole year. And people change in a year, don't they?
Yes, they do. And you know, one of the things we always say is your friends and family are going to notice your hearing impairment well before you do. So around this time of year, you're with friends and family, you don't get to see you very often. If they start saying things to you, it's probably time to get checked out.
So it's not a matter of age so much, it's a matter more of like little telltale signs?
For sure. You know, you'll notice, socially speaking, the person tends to regress a little bit. You always find grandma in the corner sitting in the chair not saying much. Well, that could be a sign there's a hearing loss, as well as asking people to repeat. They look at you like you're mumbling. They might even answer questions completely off base compared to what they were talking about. So
I've seen people who have hearing loss problems, and they seem agitated in a crowd sometimes. Why is that?
Well, background noise can be extremely difficult. You know, most people one-on-one conversationally, they can do pretty good. But when you start introducing any kind of background noise, whether it's multiple people talking, like in a restaurant, or if you're at home, well, you know, with the family, and you know, Christmas vacation's on, everybody's kind of huddled around, that whole holiday scene, and all that commotion's going on, that can create a lot of difficulty and confusion for the person who's hearing impaired.
Does a person who is starting to become hearing impaired sometimes speak at levels that are different levels to hear, like loud or too soft?
For sure, yeah. Most people who are hearing impaired tend to speak louder than normal, but they're trying to hear themselves. And so a lot of times they don't think they're talking loud, but you can tell right away. And you know, as an example, my father has a hearing impairment. If he's not wearing his hearing aids, I know right away when he walks in the house, right away.
Or if he's watching the TV and you walk in the room.
Exactly right. Yeah, the TV's up tremendously loud. Mm-hmm. They don't notice the difference, though, until sometimes they either put their hearing aids in or something's mentioned to them. Hey, you know, your TV's kind of loud. They don't notice it.
I find it sort of interesting, too. It's not just a matter of how loud something is. Sometimes it's different bands of sound, right? Different ways. Like some people can hear certain parts of things, but not the right part.
That is very true. One of the things we try to explain to all of our patients is hearing is one thing. I mean, anybody can hear a dump truck go down the street. Mm-hmm. Understanding words is where this problem comes in. And so they have a hard time with the clarity in speech, especially women and children's voices. Much softer, much higher pitch, much more difficult.
Like fluctuation of conversation. So they could be in and out, and that's why they're asking to repeat, because they hear you, but they don't totally understand.
Exactly.
Out of context.
And they might hear a difference. Hey, we're going to meet at 5. It might be 9, you know, or the street address. And they might mix up a few numbers, and that's all it takes.
Hey, you'd probably know more about this than anybody. How do you tell somebody, or how do you help somebody make that decision that maybe they should get an examination? Because that's like some people take it as an insult.
They can, you know, and you have to know the personality of that particular individual. You know, some people you can approach a little bit of humor, you know, kind of give them a little shot every once in a while. But then there's other people who are a lot more serious, and you just got to sit down with them as a loved one and say, look, I saw you today, I saw you tonight, you're missing a lot of what's going on. Come with me, let's go to Beltone, let's get our ears checked, let's find out what's going on, so at least we have the answers. Yep. What you do about it's up to you, but at least get the answers you need so you can make an informative decision.
I make jokes about it too, you know, like sometimes when an old guy can't hear his wife or this fella can't hear his wife, I say that's God's gift to him.
Selective hearing?
But it's really a terrible thing if you can't hear, because you tend to drop out of the society you're
for
living
sure.
in.
For sure. You withdraw from things. You withdraw from the family. You withdraw from those events. You tell your family, hey, I don't want to go to dinner. I don't want to go to church tonight because I can't hear. And that's part of your life, and that's part of your spirit.
And how do they get a hold of Beltone then? They get the examination and everything with you, right?
Correct. Yeah, full examination. We're going to go through your lifestyle. We're going to go through some choices, some technology choices. We're going to find out what's best for you and give you a couple options.
Is it expensive, that part of it?
No, it's free.
It's free?
Yeah, we do not charge for that. We have 26 locations, and it's free of charge to sit down with us and just go through that consultation and find out what's going on.
There's his gift to you. How about that? More to A Cleveland right after this.
Thank you much.
Thanks a lot.